First, I'll give you the tour of this room where I'm staying. So this is, as you can see, a living room with 3+2 sofa, a flat screen television, and of course we have a balcony attached with this living room. And the view is okay. There are a lot of homes. Thimphu is quite populated, but then we can see there the Buddha statue. And it's nice. The temperature is really nice here. Then, come on. Here is a small dining table. Here is one fridge. Here is a kitchen. The gas and a basic cookery sets to basically make tea and probably Maggie's. So this is it. And then there is this one bedroom. So this is a bedroom. And then we get a cupboard. And there's a bathroom. And we even have a balcony attached to the bedroom. Of course, the building is under construction, so it's quite noisy here. So we'll get back in. So this is the room, guys, where we are staying in Thimphu for 2-3 days. So now let's get outside and start exploring the city. Friends, I am right now in city center of Thimphu. I mean, it's a main street where all the markets, all the shops are located. And we are going to have something here. We're going to have some food here. And there is a very famous shop called Burger Point. So I'm going to visit that shop and try out their burgers. Let's see how it is. The approach is quite unique. I mean, there is small, this nara, and then along with that, there is this footpath which goes to that shop. Here is this shop. So this is the menu, guys, and the only thing different here is like you have to write down your choice of item on this paper and submit it in on counter, and they will serve you. So it's not like someone will come to your table and take order. It's like you have to write your order in this paper and submit it on a counter, and they will serve you. So we are going to eat burgers because it's a Burger Point. So guys, my burgers are served now, and they look delicious and yummy. So two different types of burgers I'm gonna eat them. So let's start with this one. It's good. Very good. Guys, the burger was amazing. Seriously, it was so juicy and filling. It's awesome, and at a very reasonable price. So yeah, tummy is full. Now I'm going towards simply Bhutan. It's a place, a tourist attraction point, where I heard that you can do a lot of things. So yeah, let's just go there and see what all we can do. I've reached, guys, simply Bhutan. It's a museum, and it's a living museum. So a little different. Here is the entrance. Guys, the entry ticket is 300 rupees, and things included in tickets are like, of course, the museum. You can roam around, you can taste wines, local wines. There is archery range, so you can try, you know, some archery. And there are also some local traditional performance, so you can enjoy those things. The only additional thing for which you have to pay is food inside. So that's the thing. So let's go inside and check out how it is.
is Mr. Prima Singh, the guy who was doing all the craft with his leg. He's a legend, guys. I mean, he has done so beautiful work with his legs. He has even participated in Para Olympics in archery. I mean, just imagine doing archery in Olympics with foot. That's amazing, man. This guy is amazing. Hats off to him. So this Simply Bhutan is a very small place, not a very big place, but then you get the essence of Bhutanese culture and their tradition. So there is an archery range. It's a very small thing. Just one target. I'm going to try it. Booked our tickets to go to Phuntsholing tomorrow. It's very important to book bus tickets in advance if you're traveling by bus, because there are very few buses. I mean, the frequency is less and there are a lot of people traveling, so the seats get filled very fast. So you have to book them in 1 or 2 days in advance to get a good seat. And archery is Bhutan's national sports, and you can see here it's an archery range. You can see people walking with their archery kit and everything. And it's amazing, man. You see, almost everyone know how to do archery in Bhutan. I mean, it's a national sport, but one thing good about Bhutan is, like, they promote sports. They're a small country. The resources are not easily available here. It's really good to see people promoting sports, giving attention to sports, because it's very important. It's an integral part of life and one should promote sports. Here it is, guys. I just got the better view of the archery range, so you can see there is, between the flags is the aim, and there are at the end the guys who are going for the aim. And then you can see here it's volleyball and tennis court, and then from after that is the football practice ground, and then the main football ground, the Olympic football ground. Guys, it's lunchtime and we are going to Ama restaurant. It's famous for authentic Bhutanese food. So let's go and try some Bhutanese. Guys, Ama, I mean, it means mom in Nepali and Bhutanese. So it's basically mother's kitchen, if I'll translate. And again, you can see the menu. There is a pad, it's for writing your order. And then the menu. So it's quite a tradition in Bhutan that when you go to a restaurant, you just write your order on a pad and submit it on a counter and they will serve your order.
Wow, I got this table light, it's looking good. So I was told before coming here that in Bhutan, they don't accept 2000 rupees Indian currency note, but then it's easily accepted in all the shops. So don't worry about cash, just bring your Indian cash. You can bring in 2000 rupees, 500 rupees, 200 rupees, 100 rupees. Every currency note of India is accepted here in Bhutan. The only problem you will face is with coins. There are some places where they don't accept Indian coins. But apart from that, the notes are easily accepted everywhere. So keep that in mind, because I've seen a lot of people on blogs, in their blogs and all. They say that in Bhutan, you know, the 2000 rupees or the bigger Indian currency notes are not accepted, but that's not right. That's not true. It's false. So that's the thing. And one more tip is, like, don't run too much. Like, when you come to Bhutan, try to be at one place for a couple of days. Just enjoy, just soak into the environment and enjoy the culture, the temperature, the beautiful
town. Apart from that, yeah, we have just ordered our food, some chicken rice. Patsy rice is the national food here. So we have ordered them and we are waiting for it to come. Really hungry. This is red rice, mushrooms. This is red chili and onion. Some meat. It's good, really good. Another thing which I noticed in Bhutan is like people follow traffic rules much, much better than what Indians are used to, and they respect pedestrians. I mean, there is everywhere the zebra crossings, and there is no police, no traffic police. There are hardly traffic police you can spot. I mean, yeah, so far I have spotted only 4 to 5 traffic police in the whole Thimphu city, and they respect pedestrians, the motorist. You go stand near the zebra crossing and they will stop and they will ask you to cross the road. That's the culture and politeness of Bhutan. Drivers, or let's say motoring culture in Bhutan, is really great. And apna India mein to bhai zebra crossing dhoondna hi muskil hota hai. And jab mil bhi jaye, like traffic wahi pe khada hota hai. You see this car? Kia? It's going to launch in India. And here are the clear views of the car. That's the Sportage. Oh, that's a Land Cruiser. My dear friends, apart from enjoying the beautiful nature and sightseeing places in Thimphu or in Bhutan, you must try the dairy products here, like lassi and curd, yogurts. I mean, the taste different and the taste so good. So keep this in mind that whenever you're coming to Bhutan, do try their dairy products. So that's it guys, our trip to Bhutan has come to an end. If you like this video, hit that like button, share it with your friends and family, and don't forget to hit that red subscribe button. I'll see you soon. Till then, take care, enjoy, ciao.